Good afternoon, one and all. I welcome you all for the seminar on tools for big data. First, I would like to thank the authorities of Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati Vishwamahavidyalaya, deemed to be university, shortly called Sangra University, which is situated at Kanjipuram. I thank the Almighty and the all Kanji Periyavas to invite me for the inviting session of this Tools for Big Data. Now, I call Dr. Nirmal Raj. Dr. Nirmal Raj, HOD of
welcome, sir.
MCA. Okay, you can give an introduction about this webinar.
Okay. I warmly welcome all the participants who has been joined for this faculty development program on tools for big data. And I really want to welcome the professor of the resource person, T. Velmurugan sir, associate professor PG and research department of computer science. Head Department of Computer Science and Application, DG Vaishnava College from Arumbakkam, Chennai, who has been accepted our invitations and take over for these tools for big data. And I hope that it will be very useful for all the faculty members and the research scholars, those who are like to attend this program. Thank you. Welcome, sir. Now I hand over this session to the professor, Dr. T. Velmurugan, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Nirmal Raj. Now, it is the time to discuss about the big data tools. There are various kind of tools are available for the processing of the big data. Before starting this big data tools, first I would like to get the blessings of the Kanji Periyavas. It's I hope the blessings are always reached to me. With the help of these saints, the all over Kanji Periyavas, this kind of institution is very well grown, very well elaborated, and very well elaborated and situated in a very good campus run by the advice of the Kanji Periyavas. Actually, now we start about the big data tools. Apart from this Kanji Periyavas, I would like to thank the overall head of the department, Dr. Rajalakshmi ma'am, and the head of the department of MCA, Dr. Nirmal Raj, and organizer of this event, Dr. S. Babu. Thank you very much for inviting me in order to share my views about the tools of big data. Thank you. Now, first we discuss about what is big data, a small information about the big data. Big data is large amount of data. Already we know that very well. The large amount of data may be analyzed computationally by revealing patterns, by revealing trends, by correlating the information, databases, and other things. Everything should be correlated by correlating the databases, and especially relating to the human behavior and interactions. Most of the information is actually processed by means of big data are used for the human behavior and human interactions oriented. But the trends, what is the current trend? What is the current information are actually carried out by means of this big data? Now, this big data, what is the meaning of the big data? A collection of data sets so large and complex that is becomes difficult to process using on-hand database management tools. So using your on-hand database management tools, the collection of big data are not easy to analyze, are not easy to access, are not easy to process. Therefore, we require a special kind of tools in order to process the big data. So for the processing of the big data scenario, we require a special softwares, a special kind of softwares. Actually, there are three kind of platforms are available in order to process the data: normal mode and cloud mode and other kind of modes. There are three modes are available in order to process the data. There are different kinds of tools are available: one for visualization, one for technique, one for processing, one for methods, and what like that. There are many techniques are also available in for the processing purpose of the big data. Okay, now what is a big data refers? A big data refers to data sets whose size is beyond the ability of typical database software tools. Suppose a database software tool does not capture and store, manage, analyze the available data, then we need a special kind of tools in order to analyze the data warehouse information and database repositories. So this is why we require the tools for the big data, a special kind of big data tools. So it is the next generation data warehousing and business analytics. Actually, this topic is used for the next generation data warehousing and business analytics, and it is mostly poised to deliver top line revenues cost effectively, efficiently for the business purposes and for the enterprises. So for the enterprises purposes, for the business purposes, in order to run a PACA company, we can use this big data analytics concept. Now, what are the basics of big data? Actually, the number one basic is statistical analysis. There are various kinds of statistical analysis are available. You know that very well. There are various different sampling techniques, clustering techniques, and testing informations are available. There are various kinds of tests are available. Time series analysis are available. In order to fulfill the missed data, some kind of informations are available in the statistical analysis. Then in predictive analytics, we can prediction oriented information extraction is carried out by means of, based on some availability of data, by means of some specialized kind of techniques. So all these are applied in data mining applications, data mining techniques, data mining methods. So these things are mostly used in web analytics and business analytics, but together all these things are actually used in big data analytics. So a big data involves the data produced by different devices and applications. There are different kind of devices are available in order to process, produce the big data concepts. So below are some special kind of informations, devices, the sources which are generate the big data. Social sites data, nowadays we know that very well. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and other, and WhatsApp messages, everything should create a big data, because your mobile itself contains big informations, GB oriented, not MP oriented. GB oriented informations are available in your hand mobile itself. So your hand mobile itself, a lot of informations are growing every second, every millisecond, every microsecond. So this is a social sites data. Then what is search engine data is not comparable. There are many kind of many search engines are available nowadays. Not only the Google search engine, also very kind of search engines are available. All these search engines retrieve lot of data from different databases where the actual data are stored. The search engine must capture the information from the data warehouses, which is originally located in a particular place or all over the world, all over database warehouse oriented, repository oriented information. So search engine data or growing every second, every millisecond, every microsecond. Medical history data is not possible to compare. Every time, every hour, every minutes, the medical history data are growing. Okay. Now what? Online shopping data, stock exchange data, vehicle booking data, you know that very well, vehicle booking data. Nowadays we are using Ola and Uber and Uber. Everything is used for the vehicle booking data. Then aviation data, audio and video data recordings in the aircraft, etc. are recorded, used nowadays. So the online data are not comparable. Online data are very vast, very large, very volume, large volume of data are available in the place of online data, online shopping data, and stock exchange data. Okay. Now, what are the characteristics of big data? There are four V's: volume, variety, velocity, and veracity. What is called as volume? The amount of data. How much data are available in your database repository? Variety of data. What are the different types of data stored in your database repository? And the velocity, how frequently the data are accessed, how frequently the informations are stored in the data. And what is the veracity? The quality of data, whether the data stored in your database repository are having quality, whether it is complete, the data complete data are stored, consistent data are stored, and noisy data are not available in the database repository. All these things are coined and termed as quality of data, called as the quality of data. Volume, quality of data is generated, is very important. The main characteristics of this data is big, is the sheer volume, that is a big, very big volume. It makes no sense to focus on minimum storage units. Minimum storage units are not used for storing the big number of very high volume of data. So we require special kind of storage volumes. What is called as variety of data? So variety is the category to which big data belongs to, also a very essential fact. So known as for data analysis. Yeah, different varieties of data, financial data, government sector data, and industry data, and then private sector data, public sector data, personal information, region oriented, continental oriented, world oriented, particular area oriented. This kind of data are mostly used, mostly called as variety of data. So a number of varieties are available in order to utilize all these varieties is not easy, is not a easy task. Therefore, we require some kind of applications for accessing the different varieties of data. So traditional data types, the structured data types include things on a bank statement like date, amount, time. These are all structured data. These are different varieties of data are available. Then what is veracity? The quality of data being captured can vary to grand extent, and hence does the accuracy, the veracity, the quality of data, where have accurate data, whether feasible data, sufficient data. This is called as consistent data, that is veracity. The veracity refers to the trustworthiness of data, the consistent data, exact data. Also, sometimes the veracity is the base for quality of data. Then what is called as velocity? The frequency of data, the frequency of incoming data that needs to be processed. So the velocity is the, in the context, refers to the speed of the data generation, how fast the data are generated and processed. Okay, this is the velocity of data. How much information, how much storage place we need for storing the newly generated data. What are the SMS messages nowadays? Facebook informations, Twitter informations are every second, second to second, millisecond to millisecond, it varies, growing. So this kind of data are actually called as velocity. The what is called as big data. Big data, which also includes distributed file systems, that big data must be processed by means of distributed file systems, NoSQL databases, grid computing, cloud computing. These are the application areas of the big data. MapReduce and other new paradigms, MapReduce method and HDFS methods are, we will discuss later. Okay, large scale data information, all these are mostly utilized in the machine learning techniques and the machine learning applications. Now, what is the evaluation of the database technology? In 1990, RDBMS, relational database technology, are actually developed. In 2000, RDBMS and OLAP, online analytical processing and data warehouse techniques, are actually created by the humans in the world. But after the 2015, RDBMS, some kind of NoSQL and some kind of big data analytic tools are actually used. So the NoSQL, which includes a key value column stored, column oriented information extraction, is carried out. We can able to process by means of column oriented information extraction by means of NoSQL. So document database are mostly created, utilized. Then Hadoop and OLAP data warehouse informations are other kind of big data analytics tools are actually available nowadays. But the number one tool is Cassandra and the MongoDB, Mongo database. These two tools are very famous tools nowadays used for analyzing the database, big data. Okay, so you can see here a complex diagram is given. How we can process, what are the techniques available, in what platform the big data are analyzed? Is the analyzing the big data and the processing the big data, visualizing the big data is not an easy task. So it is a complex task. You know very well, you identify, you can start anywhere else. A lot of for data storage, many kind of platforms, many kind of softwares are used for storage. So Cassandra, MongoDB, Couchbase, and Couchbase, Flame, Scribe, data collection, these are all used for data collection. These are for data storage. Then for data processing, some kind of methods are used. Informatica, Esper, CB, Spring Data, these are all softwares, tools which are used for processing the data. So data collection, Scribe and Flame are used in both data storage as well as data processing. Then for data analysis, for the text analysis purpose alone, some special kind of text analysis softwares are utilized. This is the point. Then for the data mining and the data science, we can have various kinds of application oriented softwares, R language, Vega, SAS, SPSS. These are all old one. SPSS or Vega are old and is newly now created, but 2000 itself R language was developed. SAS is only used only for business purposes. Casper and Mohit software, these things are actually available in the Hadoop, in the Hadoop platform. Hadoop is data, big data analytic tool in which Mohit, Storm, Streaming, MapReduce method, HBase, HDFS. HDFS means Hadoop distributed file system. All these are enter in the Cloudera platform. One platform, Cloudera platform. And these things are used in Hadoop platform. Cloudera platform and Hadoop platform. Now you can see here data visualization tools. Here are Tableau is number one database. That is like MS Office software. Excel like software. Tableau is very well extracted nowadays, used for visualization purpose. JasperSoft, ClickTech, MicroStrategy, Grid, these are some softwares used for data visualization. But here you can see here knowledge management. So for acquiring some knowledge, gathering, for knowledge gathering, some other kinds of softwares are used. Here social network analysis, use another kind of softwares. All these are used for what purpose means? First, user recommendation engine, document search engine, big data warehouses, big data products, analytical engine carry out your information, real-time binding, everything is goes on. This is the the special kind of actually a complex type of a big data analytic tools, visualization tools, storing tools, processing tools, text analyzing tools, data mining and data science tools, data visualization tools are used in the scenario. Now, what are the open source big data tools in 2015? Now, I want to inform you one thing. It's not possible to discuss all the tools available in nowadays in for the processing of the big data. Only we can discuss one Hadoop tool alone. In this webinar, we discuss only the Hadoop. Well, also, it's not possible to give you a practical oriented session. So because which will not support in my system, because the Hadoop system must require, in order to process all the big data, we require minimum configuration in your computer, in your system, minimum 8 GB, or if 10 GB RAM is available, then only it is possible to analyze the process the big data concepts, because the big data is not directly accessed by you. The big data practical oriented sessions are not directly associated by you, only by means of cloud or virtual machines. Virtual machine concept alone, we can analyze all these things. Now, what are the different open source big data tools? So these are all Hadoop is open source. You can freely download the Hadoop software. There are various kinds of software, Hadoop software are available. Everything is Cloudera and MongoDB, Cassandra, market software, there are lot of open source softwares are available. Each and every software is entirely differ from one another. Okay. Now, what are the different tools used in big data? Where processing hosted, distributed servers and cloud servers are used for the processing purpose and hosted. For where data is stored, distributed storage only, and Amazon S3 server is actually the distributed storage oriented stored platform. What is the programming models? Distributed processing oriented programming models are available. MapReduce method is the very famous method nowadays used for programming the models. How data is stored and indexed by using the high performance schema, free database oriented. High performance schema oriented. Why in this place high performance schema oriented information extraction is actually suggested, or the people's are suggested, means the big data itself sometimes contains a high dimensional data set. So in order to access the high dimensional data set and a large number of data volumes, data sets, database repositories, we require high performance schema oriented free database, that is which is available in MongoDB. What operations are actually performed on data? Analytical operations and semantic processing. Semantic processing is we can find the meaning of the data, for what purpose the data are actually stored, what is the meaning of the data actually stored in by using the big data concept. Then for what purpose the data are stored is analyzed by means of the analytical operations. So how much data are available, where the data are stored, when the data are stored, who stored the data, everything is analyzed by means of analytical operations. But semantic processing, we can find out the meaning of the data. What is the meaning of the data? For what purpose the informations are actually carried out, everything is available. Now, the most popular tool in Cloudera, virtual machine. The Cloudera virtual machine, VM means virtual machine. Cloudera virtual machine is very simply used. If you install in your system the Cloudera virtual machine, the loading the Cloudera is not easy task, because which is mostly system oriented. Some lower configuration systems are never accepted the Cloudera concepts, which you have some products, services, customers, partners, everything you can identify very easily. What softwares the Cloudera are mostly utilized, these companies. So our customers, these companies are mostly utilized the Cloudera concepts. So do you profit from all the all of your data by means of this. Yes, nowadays Nokia company is running properly, running benefitly. Okay, they got a benefit by using this Cloudera concepts. So what are the popular big data Hadoop tools are available? I am already informed you. The Hadoop tool is the very famous tool used for processing purpose of the big data, in which there are various kinds of tools are available in the Hadoop itself. So for the data extraction, we use Talend and Pentaho. For data storing, Hive, Scoop, MongoDB are used. And the data mining tool or Oracle, nowadays we know that very well, only Oracle. Data analyzing tool or HBase, Hadoop based, PIG, that is Borg, okay, in Tamil, Panni. Okay, so PIG is another one language which is mostly used in the analysis of the big data concept. HBase means Hadoop based. Then Zookeeper is data integrating tool mostly utilized in the big data. So there are different kind of Hadoop tools are utilized by means of this Hadoop big data tools. Okay, now what are the other kinds of tools? These tools are used for what purpose? Means processing the data, big data. For the processing purpose of the big data, these things are used. But for the visualization purpose of the big data, how we can effectively visualize the information which are extracted by means of the big data tools is visualized by means of this software. Click view, Fusion Charts Shoot.txt. It is a part of InfoSoft Global company, which is a software provider of data visualization products. So data visualization products. Now, nowadays, very famous tool, you can easily use Tableau software. Please download the Tableau software in order to visualize the information available in the, by using the minimum configuration itself. I think 4GB RAM is enough for using the visualization Tableau software. We can utilize Tableau software is very famous for the visualization. Census, there are various kinds of data wrapper, Infogram, Plotly, these are some other kind of data visualization softwares are utilized. Okay, now we are coming into the part of the Hadoop. We know that we can learn something about Hadoop. What is Hadoop? What are the basics of Hadoop? How we can utilize the Hadoop? How we can do practicals using Hadoop? What are this? How we can install the Hadoop? The installation command itself I will give you. Sometimes if you require, I will send my PPT, the installation commands, because the installation command is not easy. It's not easy. These are all installation commands. These installation commands are not very easily, effectively inform you. So I will inform. I will send you the installation commands, how the Hadoop is actually carried out. Now, what is Hadoop? Apache Hadoop, it is Apache-based software. It's an open source software framework. It is a framework which is mostly used in the Cloudera virtual machine concept. Used to develop data processing applications. Used to develop the data processing applications which are executed in a distributed computing environment. The cloud computing environment, distributed computing environment, both are same. So the data processing applications are actually executed by means of cloud environment is the base concept of the Hadoop. So application built using Hadoop are run on large data sets distributed across clusters of commodity computers. Yeah, various numbers of clusters of commodity, various groups of computers are available which are run based on the Hadoop large data sets concepts. In Hadoop, data resides in a distributed file system, not in a single database repository, not in your system. Actually, the data are not stored in your system, which is stored in the cloud, which is stored in the distributed file system. So, which is actually the Hadoop, the data resides in the distributed file system, which is called as a Hadoop distributed file system, HDFS. In HDFS format, the actual information are stored. The processing model is based on data locality. Your node, your system is actually data locality. The processing based mostly based on the data locality. The data locality concept wherein computational logic is sent to the various groups of nodes containing the data. Actual data, where the actual data is available. Fetch the locality of the data by means of this distributed processing model, by means of this cluster, special kind of STFL command, STFS command. This entire information is processed. A compiled version of a program written in a high level language such as Java is used. Mostly Java programs are used in order to compile the Hadoop systems, Hadoop environment. The Java program, if you know very well the Java program, you can very simply use this, process this information by using the Hadoop environment. So such a program processes data stored in Hadoop HDFS. Hadoop distributed file system is one of the very famous component available in Hadoop. The another one component is MapReduce method that we will discuss later. Okay, now what is Apache Hadoop? Consists of two sub projects. One is Hadoop MapReduce and another one is HDFS. What is MapReduce? It is a computational model and software framework for writing applications which are run on Hadoop. Capable of processing enormous data in parallel on large clusters of computation models. Suppose a large number of numerous data are available parallelly, each and every group is actually accessed by means of reducing some components in the availability and locality of data. The locality of data are reduced by means of some components based on this application MapReduce. MapReduce is a method in which we can reduce the number of dimensions in order to access the actual available data. That is the main concept of the big MapReduce Hadoop method. Then what is HDFS method, which takes care of the storage part of Hadoop applications. Mostly this HDFS takes care of the storage part, where the actual storage part is available. So HDFS used for what purpose? The maintaining the storing the information in the big data, but the MapReduce applications are consume the data, visualizing the data, extracting the data which are stored by using the HDFS. Okay, therefore HDFS creates the multiple replicates of data blocks. Therefore HDFS creates the data, MapReduce access the data. These two are the two sub projects mostly utilized in all group of data nodes in the Hadoop environment. Now in the Hadoop environment, there are the environment is actually distributes on two, that is based on the computer nodes. Your computer is one of the node. The another person computer is another node. Node based information extraction is mostly carried out. Now what is Hadoop ecosystem components? Now you have idea, zookeeper coordination generally used. Ambari, provisioning, managing and monitoring Hadoop clusters. So in which there are various kinds of application oriented softwares are available. Flamelog, Scoop, Hive SQL, R connectors, statistics oriented, Moffat machine learning oriented, big scripting oriented, big is used the scripting language for the big data. Okay, not the Windows based scripting language. OC, workflow, that is workflow, the method of accessing. Okay, HBase, columnar data storage, column oriented data storage is carried out by means of HBase. These things I are up to HOS, the MapReduce methods are used, utilized. Distributed processing framework, by introducing the column oriented database storage, we use HDFS. Hadoop distributed file systems are exactly carried out. These are the Hadoop ecosystem and the components mostly utilized in all machines in the world. What is Hadoop architecture? In the Hadoop, there are two, one thing is HDFS layer and another one is MapReduce layer. In the HDFS layer, two nodes are available. One is NoM node and another one is data node. This entire thing is working as a master slave flip-flop. You know very well how a master slave flip-flop works. In a microprocessor based, one act as a master and the slave act as a child. That is the concept. Name node and the data node. So based on the data node, the name node extract the information. The name node and the data node, the data node are actually contains many information. Name node act as a person. Then in the MapReduce method, job tracker and the task tracker. Job tracker and the task tracker. Task tracker gives the jobs. The job tracker finish the job. This is the information. So this entire thing is a master node, and these are called as slave nodes. So very simple, in this manner all the informations are actually carried out. Now high level Hadoop architecture. What is high level Hadoop architecture? Hadoop has a master slave architecture for data storage and distributed processing using the MapReduce and HDFS. Already I explained in which what are the information, what is called as name node, what is called as data node. The name node represented every files and discovery directory which is used in the namespace. In the namespace, in your storage place, that is name node represented every files and which maintains the directory of each and every data which is stored in your system, in your, in any database locality. Then data node helps you to manage the state of an HDFS node and allows you to interact with the blocks. So there are various blocks, various groups, various clusters are available in a data locality. So each and every cluster should be, each and every block should be analyzed, managed by means of the HDFS. This work is actually done by, this work is carried out by data node. Then in the HDFS, that is in MapReduce, master node and slave node, which are combined in both HDFS system as well as MapReduce system. Master node allows you to conduct parallel processing of data using Hadoop MapReduce. So parallel processing is mostly carried out by means of this master node. But in the slave node, which are the additional machines in Hadoop cluster, which allows you to store the data to conduct complex calculations, most of the processing is carried out by means of this last node, slave node. So moreover, all the slave node comes with the task tracker and a data node. Task tracker and a task tracker and a data node. Task tracker and a data node. So this slave node must coincide with both task tracker and data node. But in the master node, only one thing is used, one either in MapReduce method or the HDFS method. This is the information. So in Hadoop, master or slave system can be set up in the cloud or on-premise. If you have large volume of storage repository in your system, you can use in your premise itself. Otherwise, only you can use the cloud. Okay, now what are the features of cloud? That is Hadoop. The Hadoop is suitable for big data analysis because big data tends to be distributed and unstructured in nature. Most of the big data are unstructured data. There are three kinds of data are available in the big data: structured, unstructured, and semi-structured. Okay, most of the data which are processed by means of the big data are unstructured data. For the Hadoop is perfectly to process the unstructured data. So the Hadoop clusters are best suited for analysis of the big data, which are used unstructured data. Since it is processing logic, it is having a special kind of processing language, not the actual data, that the flow to the computing nodes, less network bandwidth is consumed. So this concept is called as data locality concept. That's why I am inform you, the data locality means you can have your own data locality, or you can search a particular data locality information, which is depends on your system oriented configuration. Okay, what is the scalability? So Hadoop clusters mostly utilized, that is the Hadoop clusters can be easily scaled to any context, adding additional cluster nodes, which allows for the growth of the big data. Some scaling does not require modifications to application logic. Some scaling which does not use the proper application oriented schematic oriented, structure oriented information. Everything should be scalable in the Hadoop structure. Okay, another one is Hadoop ecosystem has a provision to replicate the input data and the other cluster nodes. Suppose in the event of a cluster node failure, there is no data available in a particular area in a group, then the process is usually carried out neglecting the in order to process, in order to get the good results. Okay, now Hadoop distributed file system is used for storing very large data files running on clusters. Okay, running on data systems and everything. It is fault tolerant, scalable. What is fault tolerant? Suppose some fault are available, then it will reduce process. The Hadoop system is fault tolerant, scalable, extremely simple to expand. Hadoop comes bundled with other HDFS systems. So the entire HDFS systems is one software which is used mostly for the processing purpose of the big data. Now, Hadoop distributed file system, what is the architecture? What is the format? Okay, so HDFS client, open, read, and close. There are various commands. In open, distributed files are opened. Metadata request is actually carried out by means of name node. Then metadata flow is entered into that place. Then read the data. After reading the data, close the data. So file system data input stream is actually carried out. Reading the data, data flow is actually broad in data node everywhere. Okay, this is name node and this is data node. Based on this idea, the information are actually processed. Okay, what are the examples of vendors that provide Hadoop-based systems? There are various vendors available. Dell mostly used, Amazon Web Services, IBM. These are all some vendors used in order to process the data. Okay, now we coming into the point of the Hadoop installation commands, how we can install the Hadoop. I am explaining two modes, standalone mode and another one is sudo mode. Cloud mode, I am not explaining these things. But partly these things are cloud mode. Without using cloud is not possible. So install JDK 7. So command is available, how we can extract it. In the cloud era virtual machine, what are the commands we can extract? I will send this, so you can get these commands in this website. I will send this PPT to you all. We can run the Java programs. What program are actually utilized? The Java version, Hadoop version, command line are actually processed. A sequence of commands are available in order to utilize the Java pseudocode. So what is the pseudo mode? Another Hadoop single node cluster runs on a single machine. This is mostly used in without using cloud era concept also, we can run this kind of. Here also some kind of commands are utilized. Explaining all these commands is not feasible nowadays. It is kind of a time consuming task. So such commands are used for what purpose means? In order to create the name node and the data node directories based on the Hadoop file systems. All these commands are mostly used. So start the name node and the data node. How we can start the name node and the data node? Using the some other kind of special kind of commands. Okay. Now HDFS name node on UI. So suppose if you go to this place, you can easily find out how we can install the this HDFS name node and other things. Localhost Hadoop machine list is available here. Some informations are available in these places. You can download very easily and then you can host in your systems. So HDFS basic command line file operations. These are all very, very important file operations. Suppose if it is possible, you can take a snapshot of this, because these commands are mostly used for uploading and downloading and processing, how searching the directory, see the file content, everything is available in this. So you can take a snapshot of this screen, because which you have some special kind of commands which are mostly utilized in the Hadoop based system. Okay, now these are also available. How we can remove a file from the HDFS, or how we can remove a directory from the HDFS. All these things are very simple commands, like Java commands. How we can compile the Java program, like getting help, we can simply get help by typing Hadoop FS file system help minus help, minus means hyphen help, not minus. So which will show what are the help, how we can utilize the commands, what are the things are available, everything is shown. Now we coming into the another kind of software which is used in the big data analytics, is NoSQL. NoSQL is mostly used for what purpose, means unstructured data are mostly used. This NoSQL database for capturing and storing the data, the NoSQL data are commonly used. Okay, so what are the various kind of the, which softwares are used the NoSQL database? CouchDB, Cassandra, Redis, Bigtable, these are some kind of databases utilized the NoSQL concepts. So NoSQL provides support for cloud computing architectures, which gives the benefit in reducing the cost, increasing the speed, reducing the cost and increasing the speed. The NoSQL concepts are mostly efficiently used in many people's. Then it also provides the facility to generate patterns and trends without need for additional infrastructure, within the availability of the infrastructure facilities that you have already in your system. The NoSQL commands are exactly utilized. Then what is PIC? PIC is a high level programming language used for analyzing the large data sets. A PIC was a result of development of effort at Yahoo. Yahoo company developed this PIC software. Also, after some periods, Apache PIC, this is called as Apache PIC, enables people to focus more on analyzing bulk data sets. So number of bulk data sets are analyzed by means of this PIC, to spend less time writing MapReduce programs. By writing the MapReduce method of programs, we can analyze the bulk data set by using this PIC concept. What is the PIC architecture? PIC consists of two components. One is PIC Latin, and another one is PIC runtime environment. PIC Latin is we run in the, it is a language. In PIC Latin, we can run the PIC Latin environment, we can run by means of the Java code. Java runtime environment, how it is work? It is based on the Java runtime environment. This PIC Latin available. So what is PIC? You know very well from this figure. PIC can eat anything. PIC, I eat anything. PIC can eat anything. Everything captured by means of this PIC software. That is the special purpose of using this software. So PIC data money, PIC data money are produced after eating some all the kinds of the PIC data. Okay, what is the execution modes of a PIC data? So PIC Latin program, so which a logical plan is available in order to transfer the data, then physical plan is available, and then MapReduce plan is available, then finally Hadoop execution is carried out for ready whenever the data is ready for execution. Okay, so execution modes of the PIC data, there are two execution modes. One is local mode and another one is MapReduce node. The local node is act like a Java virtual machine concepts. PIC runs in a single Java virtual machine concepts, and which makes use of local file systems. This made suitable for only analysis of the small data sets using PIC, this local node. But MapReduce methods are used for analyzing the large data sets by means of this Hadoop cluster computing. MapReduce jobs are mostly run based on the method. Now another one tool, Hive, or Hive query language. This is Apache Hive. It is an open source project, Apache Hive. That mark, data warehouse software facilitates reading, writing, managing large data sets residing in distributed storage using SQL commands. So mostly this Hive, Apache Hive, HQL means query language oriented Hive is actually used. So structure can be projected onto data already in storage. So there must be a structure. The structure oriented big data are analyzed by means of this JDBC driver. The command line tool and JDBC driver are provided to connect users to the Hive. So this is the special kind of software which is used for analyzing the structure oriented big data. The another one is HBase. It's a column oriented NoSQL databases. Okay, here the HBase is extracted, column oriented analysis is carried out. NoSQL commands are available, perfectly carried out in this. Although it looks similar to a relational database which contains rows and columns, but it is not a relational database. Actually not a relational database, but which look like rows and column oriented database extraction. So the relational databases are now oriented well in HBase. So HBase have three major components: H master server, HBase region server, and regions and zookeeper in column oriented servers. So these are the other kind of HBase. Therefore, what are the skills required in order to use your big data analytics mind? First, you must have knowledge about Python and Java coding. The Python is the most common coding language which is used to analyze the big data in incorporation with the data science concept oriented, machine learning concept oriented, artificial intelligence oriented concepts. Most of the languages, Python based Java coding, Java, Perl, project evaluation review language are utilized, C and C++ are utilized. Okay, in Hadoop platform, you can utilize this. You must have some idea about the Hadoop platform, how the Hadoop platform is actually performed, preferred, and what are the requirements of a Hadoop platform you must have. In Hadoop platform, how you can utilize the Hive and the PIC languages and other languages. So the not only the Hive, PIC and PIC Latin are used in Hadoop platform. Many languages are utilized in Hadoop languages. SQLS, SQL databases, coding, NoSQL, everything is utilized. So you must have some knowledge about working with unstructured data also. So it is most important that the data scientist must have knowledge about understanding of the unstructured data. So video data, social media data, video feeds, audio data are unstructured data. So in order to analyze all these kinds, you must have some information about the big data analytic tools. So these things are the required skills in order to use practically doing the big data analysis, analytics. Okay, what is the conclusion? We can conclude ourselves. Big data is a powerful tool that makes things easy in various fields as said above. So it which have applications, or the big data applications are applied in various fields like banking, agriculture, chemistry, data mining, cloud computing, finance, marketing, stock and healthcare, etc. Very simply. So the with the concept of this cloud oriented, Hadoop oriented big data analytic tools, we can easily find out, analyze the big data. So now we conclude. We coming into the next session, that is question and answering session. Now just wait, I will call one by one. I will call one by one the persons, those who are raising hands in order to ask a questions. I am given only some basic information about the tools of the big data. I am not given the full scenario of the big data, the practical oriented. It is a very tough task, but easy if you understand very easily. Okay, now we can I will call one by one.
who are raising their hands. Dr. N.R. Anandanarayanan, you can talk with me.
It is necessary. Sir,
yes, tell me, Anandanarayanan.
Have Linux to be installed in the. Sir,
am I audible?
Necessary to have. Sir, yes, sir, it is audible. Hello. Sir, it is audible.
Anandanarayanan.
Sir, I will put it in the chat in the box, sir.
Okay. Thank you. I will answer. Then next person, Dr. S. Prakasam. Yes, we can talk now. Your audio button is enabled by me. Dr. S. Prakasam, you can talk now. Your audio button is enabled. Okay, it's not ready. And another person, Krishnamurthy M. You are raising your hand. The question, raise a question. You can ask me what's your doubt. You are not available. And Rajam PJ, you can ask me if you have any doubt. I think Rajeshwari ma'am, now you can talk to me. Your audio button is enabled. She is not ready. Mostly nobody is available. If anybody want to ask me question, I will unmute all your buttons now. You can ask anybody want to speak with me. Yourself, you can unmute the audio button. You can talk me now. Jambari K, you can talk now.
Yeah, yes. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, what is the main tool used in big data, sir, large data set?
That is Hadoop main tool.
Only Hadoop can use other, some other tools, sir?
Cloudera, MongoDB, everything, big Latin, all these.
Yeah, I need
used.
Only that, especially sir.
Yeah, for processing the big data, large amount of softwares are available. You can use any, but the platform is Hadoop. Virtual machine platform.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello.
Right.
Dr. Velmurugan, sir. Sir, Dr.
Yes,
Velmurugan,
tell me.
Sir, it is necessary to install Linux in the machine, sir.
No, it's not necessary. Not necessary.
It is Windows is enough. Windows is enough, sir. Okay.
Sometimes you can incorporate with the Linux.
Okay, but Linux is not more necessary for HDFS.
Yes, definitely.
For Windows HDFS, sir, Windows HDFS, it supports Windows.
But not Windows support. Actually, in the different environment. You got to understand the different environment. Cloud era, virtual machine environment. Virtual machine is not a Windows based, is not a Linux based. It is a different environment. Okay. So cloud era, virtual machine environment, you can accelerate all these things.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Next person raising their hands, many peoples. I think N.R. Anandanarayanan, your audio button is enabled. And Gayatri M, you can talk now. Gayatri M. Yes. Can I audible? I am now unmute all your audio mic. Anybody want to speak with me, you can speak.
Sir, good evening, sir. Good evening, sir. I am Manigandan.
Manigandan from Sangra College.
Manigandan speaking. Yes, sir. Manigandan, sir. Good evening, sir.
Yes,
sir. Myself, yes, sir. Sir, actually, there are all three types of datas are used in our big data, sir. Actually, structured,
yes,
semi-structured,
unstructured. All the three kinds of data
actually
are utilized.
Majorly used unstructured data. Okay, sir. Actually, how we can select the this kind of data type for our research, sir. That's what my question.
For your application oriented, whatever the data set chosen by you for your research, based on your data set, based on the characteristics of your data set, the applications of the softwares are used. Okay, based on the characteristics of your data set, the softwares and the applications are extracted. Okay,
sir.
Which depends on your data set, which depends on the nature of your data set, the structure of your data set, architecture of your data set, the behavior of your data set.
Okay, sir. Okay. Next one more, sir. Actually, this MongoDB and NoSQL. This is the majorly used part in big data. Am I correct, sir?
Yes, yes. MongoDB is mostly used because in MongoDB you can write the programs by incorporating Java, by incorporating R language, by incorporating SQL, NoSQL, and the Hadoop platform oriented. Everything should be available in MongoDB. So okay, that is, sir. That's why the MongoDB is the very famous big data analytic tool.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
One more, sir. Actually, if we need a Python and Java knowledge for
the basic knowledge, you need Java, at least Java.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Next person, who is ready? Anybody? Nobody is available. Okay. Bob, Nirmal Raj or Babu?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me what of thanks.
Sir, as I hope that the most of the faculty members and the research scholars, those who has been assigned and observed over this faculty development program, will be easy for them to know over the basic of knowledge regarding big data tools. And the things we need to have to practice of knowledge workshop like that is presented, it will also will be good, but it is not sophisticatedly possible now. Okay, sir, we understand that from the beginning itself you had been said over that.
So and I am given only Nirmal Raj, I am given only the basics, how
basics
we start.
Based on that they need to know over that the Python as a programming language and Java's are presented to learn how to work along these two incorporated along with what means the big data.
Okay.
Fine. And really it is a very useful thing, sir, to know over a lot of HDFC and PIG. You had been tell about the PIG as one of the high-level languaging tool which has been used over that, and it is supported with Yago also. As these informations are all been able to know only now from your thought. I'm very much thankful for this information that you have been given, sir. And on behalf of our higher officials, of our registrar and as well as the dean, and we need to thank you very much for giving over this session in a useful manner and in a useful way, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Okay. So one of sir? My then Babu.
Yes, sir. Sir, my heartfelt thanks, sir, for your valuable support and your extended service during this lockdown period, sir, by giving seminars and programs like this to enrich our knowledge. Thank you, sir. Thank you. And also, I extend my thanks to all the participants and my HOD and my colleagues and all the participants who are all participated in this to make this program a success once. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you once again. You,
Yes. Thank you, sir.
As certain type of extension thank also you, we needed, sir, thank for you. Other area, machine learning and artificial intelligence.
Sir, the machine Hello, learning sir. And artificial. Yes. Yeah. What do you want?
Yeah. As we need to over that artificial
intelligence. Yeah. Artificial intelligence.
You need.
Yes, sir.
AI. Okay, yeah. We will discuss one more day and another day.
Okay.
No problem. Sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you a lot.
Thanks a lot.